You missed the screen. What's going on, guys? Welcome to the 10th episode of The Jar Collection. If you haven't seen everything yet, there's going to be a playlist down in the description. This week, we're going to be focusing on the Dragon War Armor, we're going to be focusing on Slayer, and we're going to be focusing on Raids. For Raids, we want to get the Dexterous Prayer Skull. From Shamans, we obviously want to get the Dragon War Armor. And from Slayer, we want numerous things. We want to get Kriara Task, Zami Task, we want to get Shaman Task, and just general Burst Task for XP. It's not going to be bad. So, this week's team is going to be Clues, Slayer, Gems of Xerix, and Shamans. Thank you so much for watching, hope you enjoy, and if you like the series, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe for more. Nice. Hornet 63 KC, gonna test my Fang, I'm just here for some skills, and that's exactly what this thing gives. I'm sorry if you're dry on testing my Fang, I already have one, so this second one doesn't really have a use for me. So that's just 29 skills I really needed, and I'm happy. Nice. So we did 12 raids today and got a lead kill scroll. We didn't get everything apart from one of my iron friends got an essential top, so that's pretty nice for him, but fortunately nothing for me. But we get this amazing clue scroll. Yes. I'll just blood water strike this head, dude.
Yeah, right. Let me get the steam
really easy. Actually, you can fire search it.
I'm definitely right, not ego operating anymore.
It's one tick click.
Oh my god, I can't believe it. Whoa!
Let's
go! Oh god!
No. Congrats, dude. Congrats, dude. Congrats, dude. Just make some Eddie bars so I can make some element darts, and there is 78 smithing. We actually want to kind of push towards 88 smithing so we can make runite darts, but we're nowhere close to that. So we'll just use our supplies up and see what level we get. I don't think I'm anywhere near to 85 yet, but we'll see. Also, I can always buy gold ore if I need to. I have enough gold. I realized I didn't even go over the method, what I'm doing. So I'm happy callback right here. I'm full up and I go put a full coal in. And what I do, whenever this coal hits around 256, because that's the max cap, I'll go and grab some Eddy ore. So right now I'm going to hit the cap. If I put one more coal in, like set of coals. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick up some Eddy ores from the bank. But first, some coal first. And then you just put everything inside and you repeat the process like 3 times until all the coal is gone and you go back to gold ore. And I do have goldsmithing gold that's on me right now. As you can see, I can't put any more, but now I can. And they'll give me increased XP and the ice balls so I don't have to put a bucket on there, so that's the method I'm using. Pretty nice. And there is 79 smithing. We now can get ever closer to those runite darts. Runite darts are actually 88, or 89 even, but I can boost plus 1 with the Dwarven Stout, so I should probably do that when I'm making those. I get a lot of XP from Eddy bars, but not that much, so I actually do have a lot of coins in my bank, so I might start buying gold bars. I'm not sure what my goal is right now, because I do want runic darts for Theater of Blood soon. And with this chin, we should be able to get 80 Fellow Hunter. It doesn't really unlock anything, but every single Hunter level helps out with their catch rate, so we get a little bit more collections an hour now. I'm catching chins right now for Pierre, if I've mentioned it before. I still have like 140 on the test left. If you don't see a clip of Pierre, I probably didn't get anything interesting, so... I got a Arclos scroll from Pierre, so... Yeah, I was about to expect. Nothing new. There's 80 smithy. Well, you probably don't expect this during a farm run, but there is... 85 Fletching, and also 1975 total. I don't know what I unlocked because I kind of spammed through it, but I think I can make magic longbows now, so I guess that's useful. Man, that was a big chunk. There we go. 86 mining. We're just collecting some sand so we can get our 93 crafting, so we can craft our 4 sand into the torture. So I'm just using Critic Mining so to speed up the process. So whenever you're walking, you delay your animation by 2 ticks. So whenever I'm walking, it's gonna take a while before I swing this and get it. But if I pick manipulate, it only takes 3 seconds or 3 takes. So if I do this right correctly, it should only take 3 takes. But obviously, you don't always get the 4 on the first take. Probably the weirdest place to get an agility level, there's 72 agility from XP though, not bad. And there's 91 crafting, just need 2 more levels till we can plus 5 boost for torture emerald. And don't forget your weekly rune crafting XP. And there's 92 crafting, I can now make anguishes without boosting, and 1 more level till we can get that torture. And there is 93 crafting. We can now finally plus 5 boost to make Torture Amulet the best insult melee amulet in the game. You missed the screen, but I freaking got the hammer, dude. Let's go check the KC real quick. I'm sweating in real life, man. I dropped like random stuff to pick up my hammer. I need to know what KC I am. Holy fuck, dude. My heart is pounding. Holy fuck, dude. It happens. 6,336. Wait, get off me, please. Oh my god, I'm sweating, dude. 6,363. That's not bad. If I get rangers, you're gonna hear me scream.
Okay, fair enough.
I didn't scream. Here we go, 86 defense. Not really major here. I've been doing a lot of raids recently, and I don't have a clip to show for it because I don't have anything from it. I should probably start recording every single chest in case we get some item. I probably put some clips in there from items someone else got, but I don't know how relevant that is. Well, I wasn't going to record this one, but we got a third bucket. I already dropped one bucket over. I probably dropped this over too for some money because it's worth a bit. In any case, not nothing to... I kind of missed it, but there's 83 fishing. I'm currently working on 84 fishing so I can plus 3 boost so I can finish my master step because I need to fish secret eel. And that requires 87, so with a fishing poison I can boost up to 87 at 84. I know I can use an emerald pie, but I don't really want to make an emerald pie right now if I can just fish the for the levels. I honestly don't know where I got these clues from, but here's a hard clue scroll casket. Yeah. Elite. I mean, yeah, it looks cool, I guess. Wait, it's worth something. Oh my god, it's a cosmetic that's worth something. Let's go. Imagine going totally off game missing an attack level. Oops. Alright, let's go. Oh my, I mean this is an elite and I got a ranger's tunic. Not exactly useful as a count, but extremely rare. Holy mod. I wasn't even considering not recording this, but I'm glad I got it on recording. Holy moly, dude. Elite crossbow farm raids, because I've been doing a lot of raids and haven't seen anything for myself. Let's go. Ooh, semi page, please. 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 Never lucky, dude. Never lucky. I don't know what I'm missing. I'm missing 4. Okay. That's bad. Holy moly, dude. We just got a Zemi Spear on 39kc. Probably didn't mention this before, but I'm currently on a Zemi task. And I once again have 2 has stats, one to turn into lance and one for corporal beast. So here at Grotto, you can turn your spear into an hasta, which makes one-handed of the cost of 300k. You do have the elite dire dome though, it's gonna cost you half that price, so 150k. So let's make this spear into an hasta. There we go, now it's a one-handed item and we can also equip our defender with this. Very nice. Just finished up with some wine so I can get this cooking level, and there is 91 cooking. We can now cook manta rays. As I said in the previous clip, I needed 84 fishing so I can plus 3 boost for Zoroa skills, because that's my master stoop clap from Sherlock, so we can plus 3 boost to get that. There's 84 fishing. And there's the skill challenge completed. So if you're anything like me, you bought the crystal bow and the crystal shield, and for that matter, crystal halley from the wrong guy, you can actually get a discounted price from 900 up to 150k, reducing it by 75k each purchase from the wandering person. Let me show you where it is. You just go to Legia, then you go through this gate right here, go all the way west, go to Buddhist trees. Oh, do note, you need a crystal seed for this in order to make this happen. Otherwise, it just doesn't work. So, if you talk to him, he'll sell you one of the three marvelous crystal items with the seeds. And let's make a shield. I mean, a bow. Because I need it for a close time. So we finally got our plus 5 boost. I decided to do a few Zora kills, trying to get an Onyx, but I didn't get one, so I just bought a few, or sold a few Chaos Runes for the Onyx, and there's the Torture. Let's go enchant it real quick. Get some Soul Runes, Blood Runes, and Cosmic Runes. And let's make our best in slot melee amulet.